I don't think Texas blue.
You know, my town is blue.
Dallas.
Yep, Dallas Fort Worth is blue.
I guess because my aunt lives there in this term. She's the head of the DNC.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Yes.
Whatever she was last year, whatever. Yeah, she's like one of the people down there who's along with your mom, I'm guessing.
Yeah, my dad.
Your mom and your dad know each other. They probably know each other, hang out.
Probably.
Like we do up here. Sorry, okay, so this is the, enough of that. Work. Does anybody not know what we're doing here? No? Anybody not care? Okay. This is what we're doing. This is called Watch Me Work, and we're in the lobby of the Public Theater where we are also live streaming. And what we do is this is about your work and your creative process. You know, because you were here. Remind me of your name?
Nancy.
So Nancy was here last time, right? Last week. And, what we do is we work together for 20 minutes, and Annika's going to help me time it. And then we're going to talk about your work and your creative process. So if you have questions about my work, I'm going to pretend you're talking about yourself. And I'm going to turn into a question about your work. So that's kind of what we're about, because we want to help you take the next step forward. Matt and Angie are behind the camera and sound, respectively. So Annika, if people are out there, in Tweetsville, or whatever you call it. What do you call it?
That's what I'm going to call it from now on.
How are they
going to
get in contact with us?
Twitterville. Is it Twitterville? I'm pretty sure it's Tweetsville from
Tweetsville,
now on.
Yo.
You
Tweetsville.
Heard it here.
Tweeter Village.
Tweeter Village. All right, people of the Tweeter Village, hello. If you guys are at home watching, you guys can tweet your question to us at the end of the 20 minutes. If you go to Twitter and find our handle, which is @WatchMeWorkSLP, and you can tweet us there. Please use the hashtag HowlRound so we can track you.
HowlRound.
Okay, so we're gonna turn on our timers now. I made the mistake of bringing my phone today because I ran out of the house quickly. And we're going to work for 20 minutes. Are you good?
I'm good.
Okay, let me just... This technology requires things. Okay, so we're going to do the, that was the action part of the play. We did the action together, I know. And this is the dialogue part of the play, we do the dialogue. So does anybody have any questions about your work, your creative process, what you're going through, what we could maybe help you with, maybe? Yes.
Okay, I'll start.
Hi.
Could you talk a little bit about revision and revising, the process of revising?
Yeah.
I know it's a big subject.
No, it's a great subject, Carrie. Thanks for asking. Let's see. Yes, I can. Are you working with notes from somebody other than yourself?
Yes.
Okay. Because sometimes we work on revising, we have just our own notes to go on, right? And other times we're lucky we have maybe someone or a group of people, they've given us notes after a reading or a stage reading or okay, so you've had a stage reading and they've given you notes and now you're like, right. So I'm assuming you recorded these notes in some fashion, written them down maybe in a notebook, something like that, so you have a record of them. And you're kind of clear, whose notes, which notes are theirs and which notes are kind of your thoughts as they were might have been talking.
Yes, and I've actually sort of gone through and highlighted the notes that I want to pay special attention to and then highlighted my own next to those that seem to go together.
Oh, fantastic. Okay, so that's great.
So it's not all of a mosh pit, mush mash, like, sometimes after we get notes, I feel that way sometimes, like, oh no, what am I supposed to do? So you've got some clarity on it. And now
what? When is it ready to show them again?
Oh, so you've gone through and you've done the notes?
Probably more than I should. I may have actually overwritten to the notes in some cases. Knowing when that draft is now, you know, ready for it to be noted again, and how to keep focused on that revision instead of, you know, getting distracted by new things.
By new things, meaning new projects?
Yes.
Yeah.
So there are a couple of things that are tricky, because how to keep focused on this project to work on instead of new things, because sometimes we can lose excitement for the project, right? I want to write something new about that. Other times, we should be concerned about how to keep sight of the work we're actually working on, instead of how to keep sight of the notes that are being given. Because you want to make sure that you're writing your work and not the work that they want, which maybe doesn't have anything to do with you. Unless, of course, it's like a work for hire and your job is to write what they want. Okay? So let's pretend you're writing your work, whether or not it's a work for hire. You're doing the thing that you really want to do. When is it ready to show them again? Well, when did they want it? They were like, oh, do the notes and get back with us in 2 weeks.
It's not a hard deadline. It's a, I mean, I've imposed one. But, yeah.
How do you feel about
it? It's a rolling deadline.
That's okay. How do you feel about your work as it is right now? How do you feel about it?
I love it and I'm tired of it. I love it and I'm wondering if I've reached the saturation point of ideas for this thing. And whether I just need to let it be accepted as what it is and decide to, you know, as they say, leave it or, you know, keep grinding away at it.
Right. Why are you tired of it?
It's just been working on for a long time. 3 years.
And sometimes fatigue will set in, right?
I still love it.
Yeah, you love it, which is great. You love it, you work on it really hard, you love it, and now you're like, well, I mean, your question, when's it time to turn it back in? I think it's time. If you feel like, you know, I've done the notes, I still love it, I'm excited about it, but I'm also, like, tired of working on it, it's time to turn it back in. If you felt like, hey, you know, I haven't done the notes yet, I don't know what notes to do, those kinds of feelings, then I'd say you're still working on it. But it sounds like you've reached the point of your concern. What's...
Just hope it's ready. I'm at that point, you know. Everything has such, you know, just starting out, so everything means so much.
Uh-huh, uh-huh.
Everything that leaves my possession feels like life or death.
Yeah. I understand. I understand. So how many people, other than those people, have read it?
Total?
Well, yeah, the recent draft.
Probably about 10 people, including the actors.
Okay. So you had the reading, they gave you the notes, and since doing the notes, how many people have read it? You get a third person just to kind of, you know what I mean? If they could read it to you, read it for you, and then give you their feedback within a week, would that be good?
A fresh read, do you think?
Yeah, just somebody.
Somebody
just
doesn't know it?
Yeah.
That sounds really helpful.
Yeah, and then they'd be like, yeah, this sounds good. And then maybe they could talk to you about it a little bit and give you the thumbs up. Sure, send it off. Kind of thing.
Yeah. That's awesome. Fresh ears and eyes, that would be great.
Yeah, always, always good.
How do I distinguish which notes are like, okay, yes, and how, which notes?
You know, so I'm like, oh, that is a lame note. But then a week later, I'll be like, ah, they might have given it in a less than helpful way, but actually, I kind of see what they were talking about. So you kind of look at it from a different way. So, you know, and sometimes maybe not for draft number two, they're not very good, but for draft number four, they might be. You see? So does that make sense? Okay. But I would not suggest stuffing notes into your play that you don't like and don't make sense to you. Right? So you never want to do that. Even if they're like good notes, or even if they're notes from somebody who's amazing and smart and all that kind of good stuff. It means well, you know, you don't want to shove notes into your play or your work that don't resonate with you. Okay? It's dramatic. You want to draw? We got to draw! No. We did that. Look at this later. What is it? Oh, water. I was like, don't. Oh,
these are for me.
Oh, they're for you. Are you crying?
No.
It's always the last day. So, does that make sense? I know. Anybody else? Everyone's like, I'm not going to ask for anything. Yes. Hi. All right. I haven't seen you here before.
No, it's my first time.
Welcome. What's your name?
Cherie.
Thanks. And is this your relative?
Daughter.
Oh, yeah, hey, and what's your daughter's name?
Broadway.
Oh, what a pretty name. So I said a name. I'm assuming you chose it. Or...
Yeah, it's a Welsh name.
Yes, it's very beautiful. Yeah, we hear about it in, like, books, you know, like, beautiful books with a heroine named Bronwyn. Like, wow. Cool. Okay, Cherie, so what's your question?
Okay, it's about process.
Right.
What I tend to do if I'm coming up with a new idea, new
right.
play,
right.
I come up with ideas and then poetic language and then scenarios that happen. But the last thing I do is the plot.
Uh-huh.
And I always get stuck
uh-huh.
there. And
uh-huh.
I think I should have it probably in a different order.
Uh-huh.
Like the plot first and then I just...
Right.
What do you think?
Yeah. So we're talking about, so you come up with great characters.
Yeah, characters.
Characters,
dialogue,
idea.
But then the
idea,
plot.
What's your idea then? What is that?
Whatever, you know,
idea.
An idea for the play, like what it's about.
Okay.
But not the plot, just the idea.
It's interesting. Yeah. It's interesting. She comes up with an idea about what the play is about, but not the plot. But could we imagine a world in which the plot and the idea of the play, i.e. what it's about, are the same thing?
Yes.
Okay, we could say that.
Yes.
We could say like King Lear. You know the story of King Lear?
Yeah.
Kind of, sort of,
yeah.
Right? Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, so the idea, like what it's about, you know, this
older man, he's a king, he divides his kingdom, he gives it to his daughter, number one daughter, number two, Cordelia, she doesn't like love him enough, we know the story, blah, 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 the end. That's what the play is about, correct? And that's also a plot. What is that different? Are you still continue to distinguish it?
For example, I always thought, okay, because I ride a bus a lot,
right?
So I start noticing things on the bus, and
right.
I start accumulating stories from the bus,
right.
And then I think, okay, the play might take place on the bus,
right.
And interacting characters, but then I don't have a plot.
Uh-huh.
And then I have lots of bus stories.
Right. Right. Oh, that's okay. Okay. So we're gonna play this game. I think we played this game a couple of weeks ago. The 2 points make a line game. So there's geometry, right? And this is all about geometry that you never have to know. So in geometry, there's a theorem or a truth or something. It says 2 points make a line. That's a truth in geometry, right? Can you do geometry, recently? Okay, you say wrong numbers. Okay, so we're going to do the same thing with building a story for characters. Where the character is, let's see, she's here, right? And where she wants to go, here, 2 points. So where does she start out? She wants, like you have a character who wants to go to San Francisco. And she's in New York. 2 points make a line, meaning make a line of dialogue, are going to give you clues about what she's going to be saying and what she's going to be doing. Because basically you're going to show us the journey of your character as she tries to get from where she is to where she wants to go. You understand? So 2 points make a line, where she is and where she wants to go, help you create lines of dialogue. Okay? And that's plot, kind of. Is it plot? I mean, does that sound like plot? You, CA knows, Terry knows. You guys went to the big house on the hill, big school. Yeah, is that the big house?
Sounds like plot, right? Yeah.
Okay. And sometimes we just get excited about like, oh, this great character, this great character, this great character, right? But if we think about King Lear, where he is, he's king, and he's ripping up his map and dividing his kingdom. Where does he want to go? He wants to find a place where he can just chill with all his knights and friends and stuff. And so he has to go on this journey. Kind of simplifying it, of course. Does that make sense?
Yeah, it does. You're taking the character on a journey.
We're taking the character on a journey. That's exactly right. Well said. Yes.
That actually really
helps. Yes. Okay.
She's saying, I am reading the characters out, just not sure about the order for them. How do I know I have the right rhythm for the play? Because there is one in my head and one everyone can relate to.
Hold on, I'm doing what to the characters?
I am reading the characters out.
Reading the characters out?
Probably reading them.
Reading them out loud?
Yeah.
Oh, okay, I'm reading the characters out loud.
She doesn't know how to.
Okay.
She doesn't have an order for them.
An order for the characters?
Yeah.
It's the one woman show.
Oh, you know the
one woman show.
Oh, okay.
Oh,
which one?
Sheena?
She's got the one woman show and she wasn't sure.
Oh, right. There you go.
To like, you told her to reach the ending last week.
Right.
She wasn't sure how to go on those ups and downs with her characters.
Angie. I know. Very good, Angie. Oh.
Yeah.
Oh, because I remember Tina over there with the one woman show too. She had one, so she's like, no, this is.
Yeah, that's her.
Oh, this is Tina.
That's Tina.
Oh, gosh, where was I? Oh, right, okay. So she. Sorry, this is horrible, Tina. We're talking about your work right here.
So she's saying that she's reading her character out, but she's not sure about how to write her.
I see.
And
thanks, Angie. Thank you.
That's
so helpful. Yeah. Okay.
And the other thing is, how do I know I have the right rhythm for the play? Because she has a rhythm in her head, but she's not sure that this rhythm everyone can relate to.
Now I get it. Thanks, Angie.
Thank you.
Oh my goodness. Okay, Tina. Hi, Tina. Welcome back. She was here. Tina was here last week, and she was sitting over there, and she is writing a one-woman show, and we suggested that she read it out loud. Exactly. And so I would say, gee, it's like, just pretend you know the order. So you don't know which order to read, that you have several characters, and you don't know how to order them. I would suggest just pretend you know the order. A lot of times we just have to do that. We have to, if you ever, it's a sports metaphor, I don't know if anybody here watches sports at all, or football, American football. But I've said this before, the punt, you know, when they try to make the touchdown, and they they're running down the field and they're not going to make it because they have four downs or whatever, they've lost, whatever. So they're about to have to turn over the ball, but they want to make the touchdown. So they bring on the kicker. And what does the kicker do? He, she, kicks the fucking ball. Just fucking kick it. And sometimes you have to do that, Tina. And this is one of those times. So just put your characters in any kind of order that you think might be good. And you might want to, before you do that, you might want to say a little prayer going, okay, please, big spirit in the sky, the one who helps me write beautiful things, please help me put them in an order that's good. That's number one. So you leave out an order, because the big spirit in the sky has helped you. And the rhythm in your head, don't worry about the rhythm, just read it. And listen to what you're hearing, and don't worry about what those other people can relate to. Remember, a billion people are going to watch your beautiful play, so you can't check in with all a million of them to make sure that we all get it. You write it so you can get it. And I bet it's going to be really cool. Okay. One more question. Should I throw up again?
So, last week, I was told to listen to my characters.
Oh, no. Yeah.
So, I did.
Yeah.
And it's gone to an interesting place, and I wrote a scene that may or may not tie everything together, so I'm just trying to, in listening to just kick it. So, I'm trying to make a decision now. And I'm looking at the chronological section of it.
Right.
Is I am very hesitant with flashback, because I kind of,
okay,
you know, that it's like an easy go-to. So
right.
I'm trying to like avoid the flashback.
Right. Okay.
There are certain places where it makes sense. So I'm just trying to not have it be. I'm trying to hear what my characters are saying, and I'm
right.
feeling like I'm not listening.
You're trying to hear what your characters are saying.
Yeah,
and you're not
and I'm not listening. They want to, so I'm trying to look at places for them to be. I think that's where I'm at.
You almost finished your sentence. You said, I'm trying to listen to my, trying to hear my characters. I'm not listening because they want to be, and then you stop talking.
Yeah, they want to be whatever it is they want to be, and I'm trying to hear them and have them be who they are. I don't know, I've like hit a wall with it in a way.
So are you talking to them, or are you? Are you talking? Is it a conversation?
I'm trying to, no, it's me trying to hear them and not wanting to hear them. I think it's more that I just don't want to, I don't want to process through this
right.
because it's painful.
Right.
You know, and they're too bad. So I don't want to hear too bad. I want to go.
Too bad.
Too bad you have to hear this.
Too bad you have to hear this and hear this.
Yes.
See,
write it down.
Right. You can't hear your characters if you're not willing to listen.
Yeah.
Right.
So.
And you've already, what's great is that you recognize the fact that you don't want to listen, which means that you're ready to listen. Just write down what they say.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, and if it's flashback, no need to censor yourself. Just write down what they say, or write down what you're hearing them say, which is.
Time to give me things. You know, she's like, I know your process. She's like, I know your process. I know. Now I'm hearing you say, you need to put it in order. You need to write the difficult scene. That this is where you're at with it. I'm at the difficult scene.
Put on your timer. Give yourself 20 minutes and write as fast as you can. You write on the computer?
Usually. Yeah.
Okay. Put on your timer. 20 minutes. Write as fast as you can. and just remind yourself, it's okay if it's shitty. I don't care. I don't care.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Because you're going to have that voice, the other voice in your head is going to say, Samantha, you didn't get the punctuation right. The spelling isn't very good. Blah, 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 blah. Because they're trying to stop you. It's okay if it's shitty. I don't care. I don't care. I'll make it better later.
Yeah.
I write, I mean, I think maybe 197% of everything I've ever written has been to that drumbeat of a mantra. It's okay if it's shitty. I don't care. I don't care. I'll make it better later.
Okay. I'm going to adopt that.
Okay. Adopt it. Take it home. Raise it as into adulthood. And then, take it home. Consume it and then raise it into adulthood. Yeah, don't throw it up like I didn't know. No. Okay? Oh, I'm fine. I'm just like. Cool. Good? So next week we won't be here. Annika's going to tell us because this is Annika's last day with us. With her Red Boots from Texas, where the DNC is doing a God's work, looks like.
She's trying so hard.
So what? So we're not here next week?
No, we are not here next week.
I'm away.
Yes, SLP and lovely out is out of town.
Annika has a birthday.
Yeah, my birthday. we're taking the day off because of my birthday, not because she's out of town. No, it's okay. Well, you're going to be back for the 23rd. So May 23rd, we'll be back here at 5 p.m. And you guys can tune in at on HowlRound. And for those of you that are on our email list, we'll be sending out updates and everything. So yeah, thank you guys.
Thank you. Great class.